In the last video, we have studied the conversion of decimal number system into binary, decimal to octal, and decimal to hexadecimal number system. In this video, we are going to study binary to any number system, conversion of binary number into decimal number, octal number, and hexadecimal. If a binary number is given, we know that binary number is in the form of zeros and ones. If we need to convert this binary sequence into its decimal equivalent, octal equivalent, and hexadecimal equivalent, then how to convert it? First, we'll see binary to decimal. How to convert a binary number into its decimal equivalent? There are two methods. The first method is, suppose a binary is given with the fraction as 1101.11. Okay, this is the binary 1101.11. This is the binary, and we have to convert this binary into its decimal equivalent. Then, whatever the binary bits given, what we have to do, this one, this one as it is, into 2 raised to 0, then this 0 into 2 raised to 1, then this 1 into 2 raised to 2, and then this last 1 into 2 raised to 3. Likewise, 2 raised to 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. Like, we have to multiply the coefficients of binary digits with 2 raised to 0 in the form of 2 raised to n. And for the fractional part, at the right side, what we have to do, 1 into 2 raised to minus 1 plus 1 into 2 raised to minus 2. What coefficients we have to take? This one, so this one into 2 raised to minus 1. Next one into 2 raised to minus 2. Suppose 0 is here, so 0 into 2 raised to minus 3. Likewise, we have to continue in the right direction. For the left direction, we have to continue with 2 raised to 0, 2 raised to 1, up to 2 raised to n. Then the 0th part will going to be cancelled. This 0 into 2 raised to 1 will become cancelled. This 1 into 2 raised to 3, 2 raised to 3 is 8, so add 1 into 2 raised to 2 is 4. This term is cancelled. This 1 into 2 raised to 0 is 1, so 1 into 1 is 1. So we are getting 8 plus 4 plus 0 plus 1 is 13. 13 is the decimal equivalent of 1101. 1101 is the binary number. Its decimal equivalent is 13. Whereas for the fractional part, 0.11, what we have to do, 1, this 1 into 2 raised to minus 1, we can write it as 1 by 2. Second 1 into 2 raised to minus 2, we can write it as 1 by 4. So 1 by 2 is 0.5, 1 by 4 is 0.25, 0.5 plus 0.25 is 0.75. So 13.75, this is the decimal equivalent of 1101.11. This is the decimal equivalent of this binary number. In this way, we can convert binary to decimal. The second method is simply write 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, as we have seen. From decimal to any number system, we have seen how to convert decimal to binary. From that, we have seen this method of 1, 2, 4, 8, 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, and so on. Okay, and whatever the coefficients are, 1, we have to consider its sum. So 8 plus 4 plus 1 is 13. Directly we can convert by shortcut method. In this way, we can convert directly, or if we need to write in exam, then we have to follow this method. The complete method we have to follow when you are going to write an exam. Okay, we have to show the complete procedure at that time. Now next, we'll see binary number to octal number. How to convert if a binary number is given and we need to convert in its octal equivalent? You know, what is octal number? Which is valid from 0 to 7, having 8 possible combinations. Okay, so while we need to convert binary to octal, so a binary number is given and with fraction, the binary number is given, we have to convert its octal form. Octal number, so octal number is 0 to 7. For representation of octal number in its binary equivalent, what is the requirement? How many bits are required? 3 bits are required. Why? Because 2 raised to 3 is equals to 8. We know that 2 raised to 3 is equals to 8. And octal representation is 2 raised to 3. That is 8. 8 possible combination, 0 to 7. This is the minimum number, and maximum number of octal number is 7. So for representation of 7, we know that how many bits are required? 1, 1, 1. Okay. 1, 1, 1. This is the binary equivalent. 3 bits are required to represent each octal number. Kisi bhi octal number ko represent karne ke liye kitne bit required hai? 3 bits are required. So if you need to convert a binary number into its octal equivalent, again we have to make a group of 3 bits. See, we have to start from LSB. Here, these are the 3 bits. Make a group of 3 bits. Here, only single bit is remaining. So, if we are writing 00 in the MSB, there is no effect on this number. So, this is a group of last 3 bits. 3 bits, 3 bits, and 3 bits. Similarly, you can make a group of 3 bits in the fractional parts also. So, 0, 1, 0. Decimal kya rahega iska? 0, 1, 0 is 2. 0, 1, 1 is 3. You know binary to decimal conversion. 0, 0, 1 is 1. 1, 1, 1 is 7. So, 1, 3, 2. 132.7 is the decimal, octal equivalent of this binary number. Is it clear? Yes. In this way, binary to decimal conversion we have covered, binary to octal number, whatever the binary number is given, make a group of 3 and convert into its decimal equivalent. In this way, you can convert any of the binary into its any of the binary number into its octal equivalent. At last, we'll see how to convert a binary number to hexadecimal number system. Now, what is an hexadecimal number system that we have discussed in the last lecture? It is having 16 possible combinations, out of which 0 to 9 are the numbers and 10 to 15 are the alphabet. That is, ten is represented as A, 11 as B, likewise 15 is F. So, 0 to 9 and A to F. 16 possible combinations are there in the hexadecimal number system. So, if we need to convert a binary number into its hexadecimal equivalent, these 16 possible combinations are there in the hexadecimal. So, for representation of 16, that is nothing but 0 to 15, how many bits are required? For representation of 0 to 15, total 16 combinations. Okay, 15 ke liye decimal binary kya hota hai? 1111. Means 4 bit, maximum 15 hai. 15 ka binary combination is 1111. That is, 4 bits are required to represent each hexadecimal number system. Kisi bhi hexadecimal number system ko binary mein represent karne ke liye 4 bits required hai. That's why what we are doing, if a binary number is given and we have to convert in its hexadecimal form, then as we have done in the octal number, we have make a group of 3. Here we will make a group of 4 bits. So, make a group of 4 bits, these 4, here only 2 bits are remaining. So, in MSB, add 2 more zeros. We cannot add the zeros in the LSB because the number will become different. But that's why in the MSB we can add the number of zeros. Similarly, in the fractional part, starting from this way, you can make a group of 4 bits. Now, write down the decimal equivalent. What is the decimal equivalent of 0101? Is nothing but 5. What is 1101? 11 is 12. 13. 0010 is 2. Point. This 1011, 8 plus 2 plus 1 is 11. Here, 0101 is 5. But there is no representation of 13 in hexadecimal. 13 is, we know that 10 is A, 11 is B, 12 is C, 13 is D, 14 is E, and at last 15 is F. So, 2 will remain as it is, 13 is nothing but D. So, 2, D, 5, point, 11 is nothing but B. So, B into 5. In this way, you can convert any of the binary number into its hexadecimal form. In the next video, we will see conversion of decimal. We have seen decimal to any number system, binary to any number system. Now, we will see octal to any number system and hexadecimal to any number system conversion. Okay. Thank you for watching the video.